In this video, we are going to take a look at the rib tool and how we can use it to add support features to a part in Autodesk Inventor. To begin with, I need a plane to sketch on, and my origin planes are on the side of this part, so I'm going to create a new work plane. So reviewing a tool we used in an earlier lesson, I can use the work plane tool, click the front edge and the back edge, and then I will get a work plane centered about that part. Next, I'm going to sketch on this plane, and I want to create a rib triangular shape here to use as support. So I'm going to sketch in a shape. I'm going to start by fully constraining a sketch. So I'm going to right click and slice graphics so I can get in the middle of this part. I'm also going to project cut edges. Now I can come in and just draw one line at an angle here. And I can come back and add dimensions to fully constrain it. So let's say each of these are going to come in a quarter of an inch on this example. So now you can see that sketch is fully constrained. Now I can start my rib tool. So here on the 3D model tab in the create panel is the rib tool. I'll begin by selecting my profile. Now I'm not getting a preview right now, and it is because I'm not using the correct method. If you look over here on the left, there's a normal to sketch plane option, and then there is a parallel to sketch plane option. Based upon the way I created this sketch, I have to use this second option, parallel to sketch plane. Now you can see that I automatically get a preview of my rib. Sometimes you won't get a preview automatically, and you'll need to click the flip arrow to make sure it's flipping in the right direction. So one way it's trying to come out, the other way it's going into the part. Next, I can adjust the thickness of the rib feature. Then I can control which side of the original sketch plane that the rib lies on. As you can see, by the default, half is on each side. I can switch it to where it's all on one side or the other. I'll return it to center here. Then I can decide, do I want it to just be one solid rib that goes to next, or do I want to use the finite option where I can enter in a thickness for this support rib? So as you can see, I can adjust the thickness, and now instead of one solid triangle, I just get a web portion, if you will. Then of course I can click OK. You may be wondering, why use the rib tool instead of the extrude tool? So let's take a look at a couple examples of that. One thing that makes the rib tool different than extrude is when you're drawing a rib, you do not need a closed in shape. So with an extrusion, you got to have a closed in shape to extrude it. With the rib tool, you can have an open sketch. This time I'll use an arc instead, and I will create an arc out here in space, and I'm going to turn that into a rib. So it's not fully constrained, it's not actually touching the original shape. But I can come in and use my rib tool, and I will switch it to the second option here, parallel to sketch plane. And as you can see, it's just going to extend the sketch until it meets the surfaces. Then of course I've got the same options here to adjust the rib itself. So that's one key difference. You don't have to have a closed sketch in order to make a rib. Let's look at a different example. Here I have some cylindrical shapes, and I want to create a support rib in here. If I were to do this with the sketch tool, let's say that I sketched here, I'm going to slice graphics, and I'll project my cut edges, and I'll draw in a line here for my rib, and I'll extrude it. So let's say this is going to be, say, half an inch, and I'll center it about that plane. You can see the end result here then. I've got some gaps here because the extrusion is going straight forward in and out. The rib will take care of that for me. So let's do the same thing with a rib this time. I'm going to sketch on this plane here again. Then I will slice graphics and project my cut edges. Then I'll go ahead and draw in the connecting line on the other side. This time I'll use the rib tool. I'll select the line. I'll choose the second option here, parallel to sketch plane, and if necessary, I'll flip it so that it's going into the part. Once more, I can adjust the thickness and how it's centered. So let's go with half inch for this one as well. And then I'll click OK. And as you can see, a much cleaner end result here where it's matching the original circular shape. So definitely an example where the rib tool works better than the extrude tool. We'll take a look at a different method for creating a rib. Rather than create the sketch from the side as we did earlier, we can create the sketch normal to the shape. So I'm going to create a work plane here. I'll choose my work plane tool and I will choose these two edges here to construct a work plane along those edges. Now I will go ahead and sketch on that shape. And then I will go ahead and create a shape here. Once more, it doesn't have to be a closed shape. So I'll just create a quick little sketch there. Then I'll finish. Now I'll choose the rib tool. And you'll remember that every rib we did so far, we switched to this second option, parallel to the sketch plane. Well, now we're using the normal to sketch plane. You can even see the example here. Looks like what I just did. A sketch plane was created at an angle and the shape was sketched on it. So it's not previewing, I most likely just need to flip the shape. And there you can see that it extends to meet the shape. Now I do have this option down here, extend profile. That is what is extending the sketch to meet the shape. If I turn this check off, it takes the sketch that I created and just directs that straight into the part. So depending on which option you want, you can turn that on or off. And then from there, all the other options are the same. I can do the web, I can change the justification, which side of the original sketch the rib lies on. Of course, using this option, I would not be able to create a curved rib as I had done here earlier. We would need to sketch that from the side. That concludes this look at the rib tool in Autodesk Inventor.